Never type a password again. I'm going to show you how I manage my passwords with 1Password so you never have to type a password again. You can have different secure passwords for each account that you have, and you can sync your vault across multiple devices. I'm going to show you how to set it up, show you how to sync it, and let's get started. I recommend downloading the standalone app from 1Password.com/download/Mac. I prefer to not have a subscription-based service, which is the main way that 1Password charges now, but I'm gonna show you how to go ahead and buy the standalone app if that's what you wanna do. I've been doing it for so long, that's how we do it. Once you have the app downloaded, go ahead and open it up, and it may look like something different, but I'm gonna go to purchase 1Password, and then you can click here on need a license, we have them too. And then you can select buy license. This is just what I prefer. I'm not sure how it's going to look with a fresh install because I already have it installed, but either way, the first step is to go to File, New Vault. You'll set up your vault name. It can be whatever. We'll just call it whatever. For your vault password, you want it to be as long as possible, something easy to remember that you've never written down, you've never written a text message or anything, and you've never used in any other account. I'm going to go ahead and use a short one since this is just a test. The next step is to install the browser extensions, which is what links 1Password to your web browser. I'm gonna go to the 1Password menu and click on Install Browser Extensions and install the extension for my browser. I'm using Chrome. Once that's all set up, let's go ahead and pretend we're creating a new account somewhere. 1Password can also generate passwords for you, but you have to go to 1Password and create the login first from there. I like to use Alfred and the random password generator workflow, so all I have to do is Command Space, type in the keyword, type in how many characters I want the password to be, and then type whether or not I want the password to have exclamation point, commas, and other characters like that. So I'll go ahead and push Enter to copy the new password to my clipboard. I'll push Paste, and then whenever I click Sign Up, 1Password is going to ask me to save that new information inside of my vault. Pretty cool. Whenever you're logging into a website where you already have an account and your password has already been saved by 1Password, all you have to do is a keyboard shortcut, which you can set, and then it'll automatically fill in the information for you and you can log in. Pretty cool. So as you're building your vault, whenever you log in, it's gonna ask you to save the information. I would recommend doing it little by little, saving your accounts into your passwords, and then going back and changing your passwords to be strong passwords since you don't have to remember them anymore. I definitely recommend using strong passwords. There may be some edge use cases where you need to have something that you type in by hand, but this is very secure. And if there's 2FA protection or two-factor authentication, I definitely recommend it. I have it on every account that's possible. Maybe I'll do another video on 2FA later. The next step is to sync your library across your devices. That way you can use it on your phone as well. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to 1Password, Preferences, and I'm gonna go to Sync. And then for the vault that I wanna select, I'm gonna go ahead and choose Dropbox. From here, I can choose the folder in my Dropbox where I wanna save my stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put it inside of the main directory for a test. Cool, so now it's synced on Dropbox. The first thing to do once you have the 1Password app downloaded is to go ahead and go through these steps right here to let 1Password automatically fill in passwords for you on your phone. I'll attach this link inside the description box. Once you have that set up, you can open up 1Password, and it may be a little different since I already have the app, but I think you will probably follow along. I'm gonna go to Vaults, Sync Additional Vault, Sync with Dropbox. You'll probably need to log into your account, and then it'll give you a list of all of the vaults that you have inside of your Dropbox. So this is the one that we're testing. I'm gonna go ahead and enter my vault password. Mine's much longer personally, but this is just a test. And then once you have that ready, you're good to go. So now when I have everything synced and it's working, I'm gonna go ahead and click inside the field, and I wanna select the Productivity Shop account. I'm gonna click the little key on the right, and then I'm gonna click that. The first time you have to enter your password by hand. Also, once you're inside, what I would recommend is going to security and then turn on PIN code. And then you'll set a PIN code so that way, whenever you're logging in with 1Password on your phone, you can use a PIN code. If you mess up once, it's gonna ask you for the full vault key. Okay, so I set my PIN code. I'm gonna go ahead and click inside of the field. It should show up automatically. If it doesn't, you can select from a list. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. And the interface to enter your PIN code should show up. And since I just entered mine, it didn't come up. But then from there, you can go ahead and log into the app that you're trying to log into. If you have any questions, you can email me at hello@theproductivityshop.co or join the Productivity Shop Slack channel at prodshop.co/slack. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Later. If you're wondering about my t-shirt, it's from the Diary of Shay Luke series. It's where I take phrases from my journals from years ago and then I design them into t-shirts, and each has a little meaning. But anyway, Overdrafted is the one I wore today, but I'll probably wear them more on the channel. Later.